I'm just going to fly through all of these different examples here. We're looking at different jobs being cut. We're looking at store closures and so on. U.S. bank J.P. Morgan is planning to cut hundreds of jobs across its consumer division. 3M to cut roughly 1,500 jobs as it streamlines its business, so they say. Fiat Chrysler has confirmed that it has offered voluntary separation packages to 39 full-time hourly workers. That's right, it's not being fired. It's not even being laid off anymore. It's a voluntary separation. Sounds like a marriage or something. Regardless, Wall Street Journal had this. Union Pacific says it will need 3,000 fewer workers in 2020. Rail is being affected here. I'm just trying to show you all different industries that are affected. It's not just one type. You're not just looking at Sears, for example. Yeah, I get that. BBC to lay off 450 new staff in a bid to save $100 million. Different publications are being affected, all types, in fact. TripAdvisor to lay off 200 workers. eBay reportedly laying off Bellevue employees amid company-wide shakeup. And this last one here, more retailers file for bankruptcy twice as they struggle with rising debt pressure from Amazon. I think they should just give it up after the first one, but that's a whole different story. Essentially, what we're looking at right now is many different industries being affected by the global slowdown that is happening today. Yeah, e-commerce is becoming more and more prevalent. We are seeing people buying things online versus going to the store. I get that. Amazon represents 5% of total retail sales in the United States, and that number continues to grow. We're still far off, of course, from it being completely overtaking all the rest of the sales, but what we can see is that so many different industries are getting hit. All kinds of different freight are being affected today. I've covered that 100 times. No need to mention it again. The global economic slowdown is on. It is getting worse because of what we're seeing right now, the situation in China. You can't simply just spread some quantitative easing from the helicopter Ben Bernanke and make it right. It doesn't work like that. So I'm interested to see how they are intending on getting more positivity in the markets, whether they're going to actually outright buy shares at some point. That certainly could be possible. I've talked about this many times before as well. It certainly wouldn't surprise me. I'm going to end the video there. I just wanted to tell you, if you want to keep up with this information, dailyjobcuts.com, always checking that site out. The thing is really good. If you want to support this channel, all you got to do is give thumbs up. It's really simple, doesn't cost you anything, and it's a way for you to just say thank you, and I want to thank you for that.